In this South Seattle studio, priceless pieces from the past are brought back to life. Brittany Nicole Cox is part magician and part mechanic, although there is an official title for what she does, Antiquarian Horologist. There are only a few people in the world who can do this work.
An antiquarian horologist is someone who works with clock or watch-related mechanisms. Usually they're antique. They come in many different shapes and sizes, so anything from a watch or a clock to a musical box, an automaton.
Watches and clocks work with gears and machinery. So does automata. Many of these amazing artifacts are centuries old.
Automata are self-operating machines. So these are basically mechanisms that are made to mimic a living thing in the world. It's a mechanical object that is meant to simulate life or movement. So it could be a mechanical flower that blooms. It's a person that smokes a cigarette. There are many different kinds, but the version of automata that we're talking about are some early pieces that were made to mimic the human experience in the natural world.
Clients all over the globe send Brittany their broken automata. Many are bird boxes like this one. Originally meant to tweet, when she got it, the bird was missing.
And what's the deal with this guy here?
This is another, 1880s piece, maybe 1870s, 1880s.
Wow.
The bird is new, so I made this bird here. Typically they would be feathered to look like a real bird in the wild, but because this belongs to me and I, could do kind of anything I wanted, I decided to make him really colorful and just kind of make him, very hopeful looking, I thought. He has a very bright song, so I thought, why not give him feathers to match? Hearing a singing bird for the first time feels like you're witnessing the birth of a miracle.
So when he's producing that music, that's all based on the mechanics of what is inside the box.
So there's a slide whistle, and if you think of a slide whistle, you got that sound. Okay, so the plunger moves in and out of the whistle. That changes the pitch of the note. And then you have the trill, the pause in between each note. And that's dictated by a release in the bellows system. So the bellows act as lungs.
Wow, no batteries.
Nope. Everything's self-contained, just brass and steel.
Her interest at figuring out how things work began at just 2 years old.
Working with my dad definitely probably got this all started. I would often be in there in the garage helping him with his car, or at least I thought I was helping him.
Today, Brittany does much more than repair antique machines. She actually makes the parts.
These things weren't really mass-produced in the same sense as we think about production today. Any piece that needs to be replaced has to be handmade here.
Her work may require patience and precision, but these small pieces have a big payoff.
It brings such an elation. It's such an incredible feeling to know that you have corrected something and basically restored a voice to a voiceless piece. I guess what I find most interesting about it is that, whoever made that 200 years ago expected that bird to sing. Sometimes maybe it hasn't worked, it sat silent for 100 years. So to be the first person to bring that back is an honor, it's a privilege to be a steward.
Malia Karlinski, Seattle Refined.